IAM stands for Identity and Access Management. Simply put, IAM allows controlling who accesses what and how, while limiting unauthorized access. IAM refers to the set of tools and processes for verifying users' identities and authorizing their access to defined resources, such as applications, tools, and data, as well as the possible actions on these resources. Some well-known IAM solutions in the market include, for example, Microsoft Entra ID, Okta, Ping Identity, and AWS IAM for AWS Cloud. So, when a user attempts to access a system, they must first prove their identity, typically by providing login credentials and a password. The system then verifies the person's identity through the authentication process. The IAM solution then checks if the user is authorized and determines the rights to be assigned for the requested task. Naturally, the user's activity on the resources is monitored, which is referred to as traceability. Let's delve into the various functionalities of IAM in detail. Within an organization, an IAM solution enables the creation and management of digital identities, such as usernames, passwords, roles, groups, and access permissions. This is often managed through a central repository that stores and distributes identity information to other services, providing an identity verification service. Directory services like Active Directory, LDAP, or Open LDAP facilitate these functionalities. For a concrete example, I encourage you to watch my video on Active Directory. Regarding authentication, this is the step where a user provides valid credentials to access a resource, verifying the user's identity. The common example is login and password. There are several authentication factors. What you are. For example, iris, fingerprint, face, etc. What you possess, such as token, on a phone or physical, or smart card. And what you know, such as a password. Using only a password is considered weak authentication. Implementing strong authentication involves using two out of the three factors, known as multi-factor authentication. Single sign-on, or SSO, is another concept, allowing a user to access multiple applications with a single authentication, and so reducing the need to re-authenticate for each application. Next, there is authorization, which involves checking a user's legitimacy to access a resource and the specific level of authorization, determining the actions that person can perform on a resource. This limits how a resource can be used by a user. This way, rights can be assigned to a collaborator and adjusted based on their situation, such as a change in position or departure. Best practice in access management is applying the principle of least privilege, assigning users access rights only to the necessary resources for a task and only for the required duration. This reduces the risk of data breaches, since only authorized users access sensitive data. There are various ways to authorize user access, with two common examples being privileged access management and role-based access control. Finally, there is traceability, which allows monitoring a user's activity. It answers the questions, who did what, when, and why. Traceability also helps detect suspicious behavior, such as repeated attempts to log in during non-business hours or sending sensitive attachments, triggering alerts in case of such activities. This is crucial for compliance with regulations like PCI DSS, ISO 27001, or GDPR. The recorded traces are essential during audits. As always, if you want to support me and my channel, simply click on the subscribe button. See you in the next video.